So, good morning, student, and welcome to the pharmacology lecture. And we are studying all about flavonoids. Earlier in the class, we have already discussed about what are flavonoids. We have understood its definition and the type of chemical nature of the flavonoids. And today, we are going to discuss about its different categories. And yesterday, also, we have discussed about the method of extraction of how we can extract flavonoids. So before going into the different categories, we'll understand the chemical test for flavonoids. Okay, so the specific test for flavonoid is Shinoda test. Shinoda test. Okay, Shinoda test. The test solution with magnesium turnings plus concentrated HCl, it gives red magenta color or red color or magenta color. Okay, this is specific test for flavonoid. If you want to go for, if you want to check whether the extract contains flavonoid or not, so you have to take the test solution. To this test solution, add magnesium turnings plus concentrated HCl. Okay, so upon little shaking, little warmth, the color going to produce is magenta color. Another test is, flavonoid produces fluorescence in UV light at lambda max 254 nanometer and 366 nanometer. है ना? तो अगर मैंने वैसे बताया था आपको कि जब हम पेपर when we yesterday when we discussed about the quality how we can analyze flavonoids, so we have understood that there are specific tests like paper chromatography, isolation we go for paper chromatography, we go for TLC. Okay, so when we go for the detection of alkaloid, whether the TLC may UV may आप देखोगे कि उसमें फ्लेवोनॉइड सेपरेट हुए कि नहीं हुए हैं, तो उसके जो स्पेसिफिक टेस्ट किया जाता है वो यूवी के अंदर किया जाता है कि जो टीएलसी डेवलप प्लेट है, जो आपकी जो फ्लेवोनॉइड ट्रीटेड प्लेट है, डेवलप होकर प्लेट है, फ्लेवोनॉइड की पेपर है, दोनों ही को हम यूवी चैम्बर में रखते हैं और 250 नैनोमीटर पे जब उसमें पास करते हैं तो हमें इट गिव्स अस fluorescence color, it indicates the presence of flavonoids. Another color test is it's called zinc HCl test. In this, the drug plus zinc dust and concentrated HCl is added. It produces red color. And test with alkylating agent, the test solution plus few drops of NaOH solution. It produces and if you add dilute acid, initially it's going to produce yellow color. To this sample, when you add dilute acid, it becomes colorless. So this indicates the it gives a concrete test for flavonoids. Okay, so I repeat, the test one is Shinoda test. Okay, another is fluorescent test. Third is your zinc test, and fourth is your alkaline reagent test. So now let's understand the different categories of flavonoids. The very first category of flavonoid is flavonols. Okay. Flavonols are hydroxyl flavones. That is, C3 of flavones is substituted by hydroxyl group. Flavonols are formed in plants by lignification in leaves and wood. And with UV absorption of flowers, they have significant application in physiology, pharmaceutically, and pharmacology. Okay, so flavonols are hydroxyl flavones. Simple, इसकी जो C3 position पे है, वहाँ पे आपका hydroxy ग्रुप हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप सब्सटीट्यूट हो जाता है फ्लेवोन C3 पोजीशन सब्सटीट्यूट बाय हाइड्रोक्सिल ग्रुप एंड प्ले दे आर फॉर्म बाय लिग्निफिकेशन इन लीव्स एंड वुड एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ यूवी अब्सॉर्प्शन जब यूवी रेज का अब्सॉर्प्शन होता है तब इसमें फ्लेवोन बनते हैं और उनका बहुत सिग्निफिकेंट फिजियोलॉजिकल फार्मास्यूटिकल और फार्माकोलॉजिकल एक्शन है ठीक है ये दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लेवोनॉइड फ्लेवोन्स एंड दिस सी ओके दिस द स्ट्रक्चर Now, by taking flavonols, a typical example of this group, general method of, or you can say general structure of flavonoids, flavones. Sorry, molecular formula. The molecular formula of flavonols is found to be C50H10O3. So this is a molecular formula. It can even with this numbering count, you can count the number of carbons. Start with this corner 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then your from here you can start with 7, 8. Okay, so this is and then your another ring. We'll start with this ring. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and this is 9 and 10. And similarly, when you count this open ring, so it is going to be C14, C15, H10, O3. O3 is here. This the oxygen. So the molecular formula of flavanols is C15 H10 O3. Presence of hydroxyl group. The result from usual standard chemical reaction by acetylation became oxidation method. It reveals that that flavanols contain hydroxyl group. So this is the reaction which indicates that flavanols contain hydroxyl group. So the molecular formula C15 H10 O3 O. This is how it is written. Okay, when you go for acetylation, CH3COCl3, it gives you monoacetyl derivatives of flavanols and plus HCl. Okay, structure of flavanols. Upon methylation followed by fusion with potassium hydroxide yield flavanols and benzoic acid. Absence of methoxy group in the product obtained shows the methoxy group must be present at C3, which must have been lost upon fusion with potassium hydroxide. So this is how you get the structure of flavanols. By boiling the flavanols with alcoholic potassium hydroxide in a mixture of O-hydroxy, benzoyl, methanol and benzoic acid, the formation of these products indicates that flavanols is having an hydroxyl group at C3. Hence, flavanol structure is proposed as C3 hydroxy flavones. Okay. This is C3 hydroxy as 3 hydroxy flavones. I want you to all to note down these small things, and even if you are sitting with the pen and the copy, then you must at least write it down. You must draw this structure. Based upon the above proposed structure of flavanols, the foremost reaction can be dissipated as this reaction that flavones will give. Acetyl derivative of flavones plus HCl either is going to convert it into flavones, or this is a compound with removal of H3CO3. On methylation, it gives this methylation. You can see what is happening here. The hydroxyl methyl group is being added, and upon fusion, it gives your phenol and benzoic acid. So you can say that when flavones are breakdown or methylation occurs, or when it is fusion is there, the flavones always break down into phenol and benzoic acid. Okay, so this is again another fusion mechanism with benzoic acid. Okay. Synthesis, the above proposed structure is confirmed by Robertson synthesis as well. You can say ki flavanol ka structure kaise bana hai, kis pathway ko follow karke banta hai, ya chemistry kaisi hogi uski. So this is Robertson synthesis, how flavanols is formed. Since pharmacognosy is not about all about synthesis, I'm just giving you the structure, how flavanols will get its structure. Okay. Another category of flavonoids is isoflavones, isomeric form of flavones. These are hydroxylated derivative isoflavones formed by partial alkylation of C3 phenyl chromone. They form a quite distinct subclass of flavonoid class and exist as either in the free state or as glycosides. Okay, so isoflavones exist either in the free state or as glycosides. Isoflavones are more susceptible than flavones to alkali hydrolysis. Okay, so we can say flavones bhi zyada hydrolysis isoflavones hone ke chances hai. Isoflavones can be divided into 3 class depending upon the physical property. The simple flavones mimic the shape and polarity of steroid hormones osteridol and exhibit sufficient estrogenic activity, which affects the reproduction of grazing animals. Okay. Simple isoflavones. Okay, so depending upon isoflavones are classified depending upon the physical properties. Physical properties ke basis pe 3 category mein divide kiya gaya hai. Simple flavones, ye mimic karte hain shape and polarity of steroid hormones, aur ye bahut sufficient estrogenic property activity show karte hain, which affects the reproduction of grazing animals. therefore they are termed as phyto is estrogens bhi kaha jata hai na tab plant ke andar bhi hormone jo mimic kar rahe hain hormone ke jaise estrogenic activity mimic karte ho just because of isoflavones and basic animals reproduction ke upar affect karte hain isoflavone in humans diet we get from soya serve as a dietary estrogenic supplement which helps in reduction of menopausal symptoms menopausal symptoms ko reduce karne ke liye bahut help karte hain estrogen supplements so you get isoflavonoids in human diet from your soya menopausal symptoms ko jo kam karte hain when you get a menopause is going to come if you want to get rid of the complications which arises at during the that particular time when you attain the age of 50 so at that can be that time you can have a more diet of soya which is going to help you out in similar way of hormone replacement therapy they are also used in case of hormone replacement therapy when in case of removal of uterus in case of removal of your ovaries there are certain imbalance hormone imbalance happens so in that case hormone therapy ke liye bhi isoflavones use kiya jata hai they also provide some protection against estrogen dependent cancer such as breast cancer so this is the structure of isoflavone some examples of isoflavonoid obtained from soya is genistrin and diastasin and red clover you get from soya you get these two compounds the two chemical compounds you get from soya and from the red clover you get biocannin A and formantin glycosides and the aglycosides are portion of flavonoids are isoflavonoids okay are shown these are the can say these are the glycon and aglycon portion of the isoflavonoid genistrin and diastasin as the definition of flavonoids isoflavonoid include that they can exist either in the free state or as glycoside state if it is a free state then you can go to get a pure isoflavonoid but when it occurs in the form state of glycosides that means uske paas glycoside uske paas ek glycon portion hoga which is a sugar part and a glycon portion which is a non sugar part so glycon portion a glycon portion is your isoflavonoid okay so this is your genistrin and diastasin diastasin and another is your biocannin onin so biocannin a glucoside okay so these are different isoflavonoids molecular formula of isoflavonoids are the molecular formula of isoflavonoids determined first with the help of first is that it presents of hydroxyl group and methoxy group okay using this usual standard chemical reaction acetylation oxidation method and Zwickau reaction and Zeal's reaction the number of hydroxyl group and methoxy group present in isoflavonoids are estimated The structure of isoflavonoid upon fusion with potassium hydroxide. When you fuse isoflavonoid with potassium hydroxide, isoflavone molecule is cleaved into two fragments, phenolic compound and phenyl acetic acid or its derivative. So when you fuse this isoflavones with your potassium hydroxide, you are going to get two compounds. One is phenolic compound and another is phenyl acetic acid and its derivative. Upon hydrolysis with ethanolic potassium hydroxide, when you hydrolyze this isoflavonoid with potassium hydroxide, ethanolic potassium hydroxide, isoflavones yield one molecule of formic acid and hydroxylated benzyl ortho hydroxyphenyl ketone. Similarly, when you hydrolyze your flavones, you are going to get phenyl acid and benzoic acid. Here you are going to get formic acid and hydroxylated benzyl ortho hydroxyphenyl ketone. The hydroxylated benzyl O hydroxylphenyl ketone upon further degradation with strong alkali. अगर हम उसको further degrade करते हैं strong alkali से, तो you are going to get hydroxylated phenyl acetic acid and polyhydrate phenol. Okay? So this is how you can elucidate the structure of isoflavonoids. This is the synthesis. Synthesis proposed structure chemical analysis of method in final confirmed by the synthesis how isoflavonoids form. So this is benzyl ortho hydroxyphenyl ketone ethyl formate, which yield the intermediate compound and gives isoflavones. So this is the structure of isoflavones. This is synthesis of isoflavones. If you want to write down, you can write it down. I'm leaving the screen for 2 minutes, so you can, if you want to write down the synthesis of isoflavone, you can please. So this is for today, and we're going to study the next category of flavonoid tomorrow. Thank you for joining today.